That's not all. The family claims the men were sitting on their couch, eating their food, and even doing drugs. Ari Height joins us with this story that's all new at 6. Ari?
And as if all of that wasn't bad enough, the family says when they walked in, one of the burglars grabbed a knife and came after them. But in the end, it was that burglar who wound up in the hospital.
Look how they do people's homes.
This is what Tony Williams and Melissa Mounts found when they returned to their Fort Pierce home early this morning. A mess.
Like, all the cabinets were open. You could just tell right off that someone broke in the house. So I didn't think that someone was actually in the house, though.
And immediately before I can enter my living room, I see two guys sitting on the couch smoking a crack pipe.
That's right. The two burglars were still in the home. Williams says they got in by removing boards from the window to the kids' bedroom. The family had been gone for the weekend, and they say the burglars had already stolen much of their stuff and were back for more. They obviously were not expecting the family to walk in at 2 a.m.
We were sitting on this couch, and the other perpetrator was sitting on this couch. Okay.
And they were eating our food.
This one, immediately when he seen me at the door, immediately jumped up and bolted towards me. We got into a scuffle. Bang, bang, bang. I'm fighting him off.
William says even his children got involved. 10-year-old TJ hit the burglar with a hammer. 11-year-old Tammy called 911. But then this already dangerous situation went to the next level.
He bolted out the door there, hit through the kitchen, and go to the kitchen block. He grabs the knife out of the block and spin around. When he spun around with the knife, I grabbed it. I don't remember what happened, you know, exactly after that. But
what happened exactly after that, according to police, is Williams stabbed the burglar, 45-year-old Clarence Reese, several times in the stomach. He is currently in the hospital. The second burglar escaped and is still at large, though Williams hopes neighbors will help find him.
Do not harbor a monster in your home. This man destroyed my home. He destroyed my children's future.
Police say when Clarence Reese is healthy enough, he will be transferred from the hospital to the jail. Police have not yet identified that second suspect. Reporting live, Ari Height, WPBF 25 News.